turn me up a little bit, turn me up a little bit, turn me up a little bit.
It's the Buck Bandit Podcast. Hey, it's the Buck Bandit Podcast. Hey, we in this. We in this. Hey, we in this. Hey, we in this. Hey, it's the Buck Bandit Podcast.
Yeah, you know what it is. We back once again live on the Buck Bandit Podcast. Episode 36.
Yes, sir.
Pick up the sticks, nigga. You already know.
Let's get it.
Old school Jerome Bettis and his bitch. You know what I'm saying? It's your boy Buck Bandit Reno.
Your boy Buck Bandit P.
You know what I mean? It was another episode, man. Another hot week. You know what I mean? Been getting showed a lot of love. We appreciate it.
Appreciate all the love as always.
And if you're watching right now, make sure you subscribe, man. Subscribe. YouTube.
Definitely,
you know what I'm saying? Apple, Anchor, Spotify, wherever you can listen to your podcast. Make sure you subscribe, and make sure you subscribe right here, right now on YouTube while you're watching, man. It's right below us, man.
You already know.
But we gonna get into today's show, man.
Let's get into it. You know what I mean?
You know what I mean? We look forward to this every week.
For
you know,
sure.
Bringing y'all that fire as usual.
That hot fire. Thailand's been hot fire.
Yeah. You already know. So this first thing we gonna get into definitely is not shocking, but it is. You know what I'm saying? They try and cancel the boy Dave Chappelle, man.
Oh, didn't see you sitting there. What you doing there, man? What you doing here? I know why you here. You want studio time. Well, lucky you. We down here during the corona times. And as long as you got your mask and disinfected, come on down, man. $40 an hour, $100 for 3 hours, $180 for 5 hours, man. Management deals, monthly deals, whatever you need. Come on down to Buck Bandit Studio, man. Now get out of here, man. Get out of here before I catch that rona.
Trying to cancel the legend.
Trying to cancel somebody.
Well, I mean, Dave Chappelle, the last comedian that say what he feel. You know what I mean? You get rid of Dave Chappelle, who left?
Yeah, he the last of the Mohicans for real. You know what I mean? Man, you get rid of him, ain't nobody gonna be able to say shit.
Real shit.
It's crazy out
you
here.
Protect Dave Chappelle at all costs, man. For real.
Yeah, but yeah, I heard on on the Netflix special, The Closer. You know what I mean?
He had a couple of choosy comments.
Yeah, I mean, about the transgenders or something. It's supposed to,
as usual.
Matter of fact, I think what it was, he was making a reference. He was talking about the baby or something, how he supposedly killed the nigga in Walmart or something.
Yeah.
And he's still out. But then he said some shit about gay people or something, and then they canceled him. So he basically made the joke like, you could kill a nigga, but you can't hurt a gay person's feelings. You know what I mean? Like, so the gay motherfuckers got mad at that and they trying to cancel. But where's the lie?
I mean, them trying to cancel the baby is bullshit anyway.
Right.
So now you gonna try to cancel anybody who got comments on it and like
cancel.
You know what I mean? Like
any
people gonna say what they want to say. You can do all this cancel shit. What that mean? They not gonna get on a mainstream network. I mean, with the internet, you don't even need.
Somebody,
you know what I'm saying? You don't even need the people that you thinking you need to put your shit out there. So at the end of the day, you know what I mean? Fuck all that charge. Cancel Dave Chappelle shit. Nigga, we gonna watch his shit. We gonna tune in. You know what I'm saying?
And niggas gonna crack the fuck up.
And real shit.
Nigga, where the lie at?
Real
shit. He wasn't lying. He told the motherfucker.
You wouldn't cancel somebody. You wouldn't try to cancel somebody if it was a lie. All
right.
You wouldn't try to cancel him if it was a lie. You would just come out and go against what he's saying.
Yeah, no, that.
You know what I mean?
That's a bad joint, though. But they trying to take motherfuckers' freedom of speech away. That's what they trying to do. Like, nigga, you can't
using,
say what you want to say.
They're using cancel
nigga.
Culture to take away your freedom of speech.
Right.
That's exactly what they doing.
Fuck that. I'm talking my shit.
Real shit.
I'm a voice how I fucking feel. Fuck that.
They wait till you get the millions of dollars and then they threaten to take it away from you if you keep talking.
Right.
And Dave Chappelle, you know what I'm saying, was never one of them people that you was going to hold down for money. You
that
seen
nigga,
that when he left that first
down
deal.
$50 million 15 years ago. So that was probably like $100 million by now.
Exactly.
So you know you can't buy that nigga. Certain motherfuckers you could buy, Dave Chappelle ain't one of them.
Real shit.
You
real
ain't
going to
threaten him with, we going to take these millions away. He going to be like, so?
Well, first of all, you can't take what he got. So what you going to say, you ain't going to give him more?
Right.
There's always a lane for a goat. my nigga. You know what I'm saying?
That shit.
So at the end of the day, Dave Chappelle, keep doing your thing, man, because all this cancel culture bullshit is bullshit. That's just what it is.
Definitely like, what it is.
You know what I mean? You can't say what you want. And on top of that, he a comedian. And if anybody can say shit like that, it should be able to be a comedian.
Right.
You know what I mean? It's meant for them to, like, the whole comedy shit is for them to take pain and turn it into laughter. You know what I'm saying? Like, so you cancel Dave Chappelle, bro? Oh, no, it's going to be an uproar. You can't. You can't.
Yeah, no, Netflix ain't doing none of that. You think Netflix going to take Dave Chappelle shit off the joint?
Hell no.
Get the fuck out of here.
After that shit, Dave Chappelle
just
going
to have
crying.
To be mad.
Like, yeah, hell yeah.
They not taking that shit down. You tripping.
At the end of the day, nothing he's saying ain't, whatever he said ain't worse than the shit he been saying. So it's like, now you gonna cancel him over this because it's over somebody they canceled and it was stupid to cancel him. So they trying to cancel the person who calling him out. For, you know what I'm saying?
That shit just, you know what I mean? Like, no. Shit. This shit is just dumb. What? I don't get it. Like, I don't get it. Like, fuck that. Motherfuckers gonna say what the fuck they feel. Nigga, you want some bullshit? You want some bullshit. Like,
and then on top of that, what do you feel? Do you feel like comedians should stay in pocket and just stay with the strict funny shit? Or I mean, it should be more to speak up like Dave Chappelle? You know what I'm saying?
Dave Chappelle is the only one that speak up. It ain't no more. You know what I mean? Like, so it is what it is. Like, I ain't putting no names out there, but it's some fucking heavy hitter comedians who fucking in movies got the big bag and all that
and
shit.
And they don't say
and
nothing.
They don't say nothing. Mm-hmm. Nigga, they keep that shit. They stay right away from that shit.
Real shit. So,
like, money controls certain motherfuckers and some motherfuckers
some
ain't
people
controlled
don't.
By money.
Some
so.
You do, some you don't.
You know what I mean? So, if you could threaten a motherfucker with that, like, yeah, I'm going to take your bag away. And they be like, oh, you know what? I'm sorry.
Like, when it come to that, then you going to threaten them every time. Because they're going to be like, all right, I'm sorry.
Get your bitch ass back in line,
you
dog.
Just going to be a sorry motherfucker. Sorry motherfucker.
Get your bitch ass back in line. But, yeah, shout out to Dave Chappelle, man. Always holding it down for the real ones. He just say what everybody else be wanting to say. That's all. Yeah. You know what I mean? Yep. What the motherfucker scared to say, he going to say that shit.
Cause yeah, listen, his concerts is thrown in his backyard, nigga. Like, what are you canceling?
Yeah, you can't. You know what I'm saying? Him. He got his own motherfucking lane. He can eat a dick at this point.
You know what I mean? Fuck shout out to Dave Chappelle, man. Keep doing what you're doing. Keep speaking up, and you already know. Like, first of all, the comedy community got your back, and all of us viewers, you know, you probably one of the main people we tune into. To make laughter out of the bullshit that be going on.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Right. Who else do you turn to for comedy at those times besides the Dave Chappelle?
And Dave Chappelle a goat with it because he'll give you some comedy and then, you know what I mean, put your guard down, then he gonna give you some real shit. You know what I mean? Like, no, everybody's like, ha, ha, ha. And
sure.
Then he gonna say some
but
real
shit. But I'm saying the comedy
shit.
Be
like,
real shit. It's just,
that's what I'm saying. Just,
the way he lined it up is just like, genius. You feel me?
Yeah, he's definitely a goat at that shit, dog. Like, it's none other like that, nigga. Like, hey, he's a good with that one.
Yeah, you already know. Lie. So, in the way that the time's going, there's never going to be another one.
Yeah,
cause soon you ain't going to be able to say shit.
Yeah, no.
He going to be the only person that can say what the fuck he want, how he want, when he want.
Right.
And, you know what I mean?
Like it or not, motherfucker. You
and still get his bag.
Exactly.
Real shit.
Yeah.
But yeah, we going skirt. You know what I mean? Shout out to Dave Chappelle, man. You ain't canceled over here. You know what I'm saying?
You already know.
This next thing we want to talk about.
Well, what's that?
Man, listen. 18 ex-NBA players are charged in a $4 million insurance scheme. Including Tony Allen. We talked about him a couple episodes ago. And Big Baby Davis.
Tony Allen.
You know what I'm saying? Sebastian Telfair. You remember him on the old game?
No.
On the old game. Even if you ain't know him, you remember the old game.
That's fucked up.
Hey, man. NBA 2K and all that shit. That shit really helped people be noticed. Nobody would know. Nigga, nobody knew who Livingston was in our group until I was balling with that nigga on 2K. You know what I'm saying? But, it was more players. But when you think about it, like 18 players, $4 million, what's that, like $50,000 a piece? That ain't shit.
niggas be popped, dog. Like, motherfuckers think because niggas on TV and they on basketball teams. Like,
well, these ain't big contract players, though.
Yeah, I was just trying to
these
say.
These is like role player
so
players.
So think about it. If them niggas living million-dollar lifestyles and they role players, nigga.
First of all, they should have never been living million-dollar lifestyles because they never got those
up.
Millions.
Niggas be trying to keep up. Yeah, big baby keep up with probably trying to go out with Rondo and Ray Allen and them, and they like.
And them niggas eating fucking lobster supreme, golden lobster. This nigga want some too.
Yeah, bro, you tripping? No. Stay in your Lizane. What you saying? $4 million? 18 a year?
18 niggas on $4 million.
That's definitely.
If I hit a jackpot 40, for $4 million specs. And I felt out, I had to split it with 17 niggas.
Yeah, that's not.
I would have been mad.
That's not
shit.
A jackpot, nigga. Man,
fuck this.
That's a year worth of work for an average
motherfucker.
That ain't shit. What
real
the
shit.
Fuck? Yeah, that's a bad joint though. But
for the simple fact that they had to do that. Like fucked what? I feel like the NBA should have some type of like package for after players
leave.
Yeah,
none of that. That's
or some way where they deduct.
That's another thing about
they deduct from their check like a fucking tax.
Uh-huh.
And then at the end of their career, whenever they retire, mm-hmm. they get that money. Like they need to set up shit like that for NBA players.
No, they not going to do
it. No, I understand they not. But I'm just saying from a
for
thought
sure.
in the conscious
for
mind
sure. I
for
mean,
shit
if
to go. With to avoid shit
you,
like this.
Yeah, if you,
you know
fuck,
what I'm saying?
They don't give a fuck about that. Ain't on them.
Yeah, here go your money. You know what I mean? Do as you please.
Do whatever the fuck you want to do. Like, they don't give a fuck, dog. Like, motherfuckers definitely need to be wise about fucking getting them six figures. Because if you in the league, you definitely getting at least six figures. So I ain't
no, that's
to,
for sure.
Yeah, you know what I mean? Like,
I never heard of nobody getting less than 100,000.
Yeah, the minimum, like, six figures. So you definitely getting six figures. So you better, and you been in the league for years, you better learn how to fucking do something. Nigga, like, cause they gonna rape you. It ain't no pension for no basketball.
First of
player,
all, 100,000. I never heard of
you
a mean? Player getting less than
I think,
one
I
point.
I think the minimum like
1 point
something
mil.
Or something. Like I think the it, like a bench warmer.
No,
it used to be like 250, 250,000.
Oh, cause
probably,
the shit I seen, it be 1 year deals minimum 1 point like 2 mil.
Yeah.
I think the minimum now be like 1.2 mil, bro. It's just the new CBA.
But I know it's a minimum. The minimum probably like 400K or something like that. But either way, nigga, like.
Yeah,
no
maybe
pin.
Like on a two-way contract or some shit like that, but no, the minimum for like all them niggas be getting 1 year deals, the minimum be like 1.2
that's
mil.
The nice nigga.
But that's
you're
still
about,
nothing though.
You talking about Sebastian Telfair, bro.
And no, and back then? Days. Oh hell no.
Them niggas was
back then, yeah. They was making like 400K for
25.
Yeah, role player 400K.
Like
yeah.
Games.
Yeah. No, real shit.
Like, you know what I mean? But yeah, now the minimum might be like 800K or something, you know what I mean, all that, but niggas that still go broke. Ain't no pension. You living that lifestyle. It ain't no pension plan. You gotta pay for all your medical out of pocket.
All
and
your,
on top of that, you the nigga who made it in the family, so you know you gotta take care of at least
all your
five
peoples,
other niggas.
And you know your
mean?
Travels like, you do with your family.
Yeah.
And your crib.
Right.
And the maintenance.
They
first of all, you go get a
$300,000,
$400,000 crib. And knowing you gotta maintenance that shit. So now you maintenance that on
shit.
Top of the people you was just
real
talking
shit.
About.
Like,
you know what I mean? Now your squad, though. Your squad gonna roll with
real.
You.
Now they wanna come to the games, you only getting like two free tickets. You got 10 niggas.
You
gotta
pay for
game.
The other ticket.
Like,
yeah,
yo,
you know
that
what I'm saying?
Shit
yeah.
real, dog. Like,
then hold up. We ain't even talk about your gear and shit in your will. You want the nice will.
And we ain't
you
even
want
talk
nice
about
gear.
Fucking taxes, nigga. So that 400,000
oh,
that
yeah.
you get taxed.
That
shit
gotta be
like
200.
You know what I mean? Like all that shit play a part, dog. And niggas don't realize that shit. Like, and that shit ain't nothing. It's sad to say, but niggas ain't nothing but high price slaves. Like, if you don't set your shit like, the only difference between them and the actual slave is they actually getting paid. But like you said, it ain't no pension. You pay 8 years.
They not getting beat though.
You just a rat.
They ain't getting beat though.
Right. You know what I mean?
You know what I mean? But they definitely making them niggas change their names to Toby and shit. You know what I mean?
Like,
cause they give them
up.
Nicknames and make them happy about it. No, nigga, I'ma call you.
Real shit, dog. Like, that shit is raping you records, dog. It definitely. Chris Paul, they all need to work on that. Work on a player pension or something. Nigga, ain't no way you making six figures and you're on the least.
No, it's some real shit. I see both sides.
Your career.
Because through us talking, I'm like, you right, my nigga. Like, if somebody came in here right now and gave us 60 mil and they say, yo, this for the year, we need y'all to drop a
we
podcast.
Ain't giving y'all shit else.
We need y'all to drop 2-3 podcasts a week.
Yeah.
This for the whole year. Have it out by this time every drop day.
That's on you.
Nigga, and by, before the 3-4 months in, you ain't got shit.
Yeah.
They ain't got shit to do with them.
Shit. Antoine Walker, a motherfucker who was getting a bet. Now, I know he was getting bread. That nigga fucked up right now.
But the bread was still lower back then than it is now. They wasn't getting no 200 mil for 5 years.
Yeah, fuck no. But yeah, Antoine Walker was definitely one of the premier players at the time getting a bag. Was nice. And that nigga broke. Sure. You know what I mean? Like, that nigga fucked up right now. Like, so that shit real. Life after basketball. Niggas need to do series of that. Like, we about to start doing that. Life after basketball. Who really still eating? Because niggas be hurting out here.
I mean, the niggas that's eating, you usually know about. Like, the Shaqs and them like that. Because they make investments. You know what I'm saying?
That's the exception to the rules. Because most of them niggas be scrambling after the... That's why they be doing anything. Doing
so, what you think? What you think they should do? Like, you, because they say they've been indicted, but what do you think they should do?
That's
should
fucked up. Should now them niggas? I pay for lawyers. Yo, that's fucked up, dog. Like, that's raping you. Because
if you think about it, this is probably some joint that one of them suggested. He'd be like, no, it's an easy bag. Just say this.
Right.
And you know what I mean? You get this, and it started off like that. Yeah. Then it became 18 niggas doing it. And now they're like, wait a minute. Dang. All y'all niggas with the same, 18 niggas with the same claim. Let me look into this shit. And then they looked into it, and they said it showed that certain players were in different states or different countries when supposedly they was getting the rehab shit and shit like that.
Shit.
So that just told on this. They didn't even stay in the same city as they were supposed to get in the rehab around the time they were saying they was getting it.
That's fucked up.
So that was just not planning.
Yeah, I didn't say, y'all you just put was, that on yourself.
They got so they did it probably did it for so long that they got so comfortable that they like, man, just submit that joint. I'm going to Hawaii, nigga. I'm not going to stay home
right.
just to collect that. Just send me my bread. Right. And they didn't think it was going to catch up. But NBA always going to try to figure out a way to get their money back. You tripping.
Them insurance claims and all that. And the IRS, that's one thing. One thing I do not fuck with is the I, the R, and the S, nigga.
Oh, yeah. Those three letters.
Get they bread,
I
nigga,
skip when no I say my what. Alphabet.
They going to get
and the
bread.
F and the B. I skip all that.
Straight up. Like, I ain't fucking with them peoples. Straight up.
Yeah, but that's crazy that they even had to, like, go that's through that just up, to, man. You know what I mean? Just to get a couple extra dollars. And they was players in the NBA, man.
Obviously,
like,
they needed that shit. They wouldn't have did that shit if they ain't need that little couple extra dollars.
Oh, yeah.
So.
But some niggas greedy. You ain't know. A couple of them probably could have been eating and said, yo, nigga, that's a free, $50,000 every couple weeks. You know what I mean? I'll take it. You know what I mean? Why not?
Yeah.
Go spend that on a lady and shit every time it come. Hey, baby, check it. You know what I mean?
We going out to eat tonight.
Mm-hmm.
Ocean Prime, baby.
On the NBA. Thanks, Adam.
Dang. Got him.
We going to skirt, skirt.
Skirt, skirt.
We going to turn the wheels again. You know what I mean?
Buck Bandit P here to tell y'all once again, fresh buck gear is in. So make sure y'all copping up on that buck gear. We got it from the adult sizes all the way down to the kids sizes, shirts, hoodies, all kind of flavors, custom colors, whatever you need. Just make sure y'all get at us. You hear the phone is popping right now for this new buck gear. So make sure y'all get at us. Follow us on the Instagram at Buck Bandit Clothing, or you can follow us on Twitter at Buck Clothing, or hit us up on that email. That's buckbanditclothing@gmail.com. You already know what it is. Let's get it.
And the next thing we gonna get into, you know what I'm saying, is this Deontay Wilder versus Tyson Fury, man.
Yes, sir.
It was listen,
the brawl. Did you,
we talked about it before. We talked about two. We talked about one and two. And I guess we both kind of seen it the same, where it was like Tyson Fury was just too nice. And it showed, man. Like, he got knocked down twice early, got up like the Undertaker and shit. And came back and took it to him, like,
came back with a vengeance.
He got a second and third win. And the nigga was like 320.
Overweight, out of shape, and that's crazy. As you go to show, man, the skills pay the bills.
No, the skills but definitely pay the bills.
That's
bro.
Really will, like, for real, for real. At a certain point, that's just will.
That no, will was willpower was what like. Deontay had when he was getting beat like motherfucking Tina.
But I ain't gonna lie, man. Shout out to Deontay though, because that The way he took that fucking beating like a runaway slave, dog. Niggas can talk shit. Ain't nobody taking a beating like that. And the nigga, niggas staying down, nigga.
Why
nigga
you like, laughing? You got me laughing. Like, that yo, shit was crazy.
That nigga took a hell of a beating. Like, I would have been like, yo, after he hit, yeah, I'm cool. Like,
it's like, I say after like the second, third round, he just looked gassed the rest of the fight. Like, yeah. like he just fucking smoked cigars and fucking fuck bitches and drank all night. It just looked like, I don't understand. You had all this time prepared. You know what this fight is about. And the least you can have is stamina for the fight.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? He did knock him down twice. I give him that. He knocked him down twice early. So I was like, damn, like he might get it back if he finish him off. Yeah. But after Fury got that second win, and he never got his second win, and he was just walking with his fucking hands down, rubbing his fists, swinging in one hand. I'm like, yo, what the fuck?
Yeah.
He started looking like a beginner a little bit.
Yeah,
I'm like, he ain't Bob at all. He was just taking the jabs, and he was just looking for that one hit for like 8 rounds.
Real shit. I mean, I don't know what was up with that nigga, dog. I don't know, because like you said, that nigga looked gassed. I don't know. After he knocked him down, I guess he must have got complacent. He, like, all right, yeah, I got him now.
And then all
none of that. None of that.
You should have knew from that last fight when he got up like the Undertaker. Boom. You know what I'm saying? You should have knew.
Yeah.
You should have knew, bro.
Yeah, I ain't
Tyson Fury was like still that. Fast. With all that weight, he was still fast. He still had more movement. And I ain't gonna lie, at first I was mad, but then I'm like, damn, that's a strategy. Cause if he could keep getting away with it, where he kept like pushing his head down, then uppercutting him back up, he kept catching Deontay. I'm like, man, if I was Deontay Wilder, I would have started doing that shit back. Wham! Cause you can't move your head if a nigga, but when he got his head up, he wasn't moving his head anyway. It was like, oh, all right, well, he didn't really even have to hold his head down for the uppercut. He could have just uppercut. Yeah.
And after a while, that nigga started looking punch drunk. Like, he just was like, and he got caught with enough of them drunk. Yeah. This nigga just wasn't even, I guess he couldn't see the punches coming. This nigga is getting knocked up.
I ain't want to say this on this, man. But we in the media, and you just got to keep it real. And it was like, when I watched that fight, I was thinking to myself, why did I even like Deontay Wilder? I don't even want to say this shit.
He used to be a beast, though. That's crazy.
But I'm just saying, like, when I see a fight, I'm like,
he met Tyson Fury.
I'm like, I know what I seen used to be better from him than that.
Yeah.
I know it got to be something like, why did I even? I was questioning myself in the middle of watching the fight, like, what made me like Tyson?
So is it Wilder?
Deontay Wilder.
Is it Wilder really not that good, or Tyson just really that good? You know what I mean? Like, which one is it? Like, you think Wilder, he just was overhyped, or Tyson just was?
I just feel like
he wasn't keeping.
You usually get bullies in school.
Uh huh.
You fucking. It's usually a kid that's left behind a grade or two.
And nigga a ringer and
yeah,
shit.
Yeah, and he beat up everybody.
Nigga really
he beat
18,
up everybody
because
he,
really
he left back. But then when they move him up to his regular grade, his real grade, and everybody just as big as him, if not bigger, they make him look like he was one of the kids he was bullying. Yeah. And I just feel like he just met somebody who can actually fight. And withstand that could take a punch. Because from what I'm seeing is, if Tyson Fury could get up from his hits and he like, oh my God, he got up.
Right.
Then it's like, everybody he fought before had no chin like that.
Yeah.
You feel what I'm saying? Now, I'm not going to take away from Tyson Fury. He definitely got hands. Yeah. But I really haven't seen him fight nobody else besides Deontay Wilder. The other Jones I saw he fight, he definitely like,
yeah,
he definitely outclassed them. It just looked easy for him. But
right,
I didn't really know who the other people were. So
Deontay Wilder
is the first person I've really seen. Like I knew who he was. I felt like I really liked him before they even fought. So I'm like, oh yeah, Deontay Wilder just gonna hit him with that one. But once I seen he can get up from that, I'm like, oh yeah, all he gotta do is outbox him.
Yeah. Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? That's what it was. Like, he's a better boxer. That's just what it is.
Yeah, that's what I think it is. He a better boxer. And even though it don't look like he training, he was working on something.
Shit. His hands was working. His body might have been still, but that nigga hands was working, nigga.
She the quickest 300.
That nigga hands was moving like Charlie Brown feet and shit, nigga.
Yo, that nigga used that nigga as a speed bag. Just boom, 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 boom. I'm like, damn.
Because I ain't gonna lie, I feel like everybody was pulling for Deontay Wilder because his personality, like, you know what I'm saying? His personality is like he got the right type of mindset to be a champion. He gonna be around. He gonna be promoting. He gonna, like Tyson Fury, not like that. He gonna get
Tyson
his bag.
Fury
he
is gonna go right.
He gonna go
back and hide,
home.
Nigga.
He gonna go home. You know what I mean? Chill. Do what he do. You know what I mean? So I think Deontay Wilder would be better for boxing, but shit. And not fighting like that.
Not if you can't fucking box.
Man. Not if you can't. Like,
I mean, shout out to him though. I don't want to trash him too much because he took a hell of a beat, and like I ain't gonna beat him up too much on him. But like, shout out to him for fucking taking that beat like a fucking man, like a stand up guy. Because
he
a lot
ain't
of
tap out.
Ain't fucking. Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Like, because I know I'm tapping out, nigga.
Yeah,
like,
you know what else? I think the refs didn't stop the fight because they didn't want the same thing to happen as the other one where he tried to say. They stopped the fight too early.
Right, right, yeah.
So he like, all right, go ahead.
That's another
There's blood
thing.
Coming out your ears and every hole. Your ears, your nose, your mouth. It might be coming out your ass the way this fight going.
Everybody
you know
see
what
the punches coming,
might
but
be,
you don't. Like,
them body shots, you might be pissing blood too. You know what I'm saying? But I'm not going to stop it because I don't want nobody to say premature ejaculation. You know what I'm saying?
Since the second fight when he was saying all these excuses. Oh, yeah, the thing was my suit was too heavy. And
so he
that,
come in with no suit this time.
You know what I mean? So listen, dog, like. It's a loss.
Like, yeah, and lost, I'm not thinking about that. Before he blamed the stamina problem on the suit. What's the stamina problem
right,
now?
Yeah, no, dog. Like,
you know what I'm saying?
You ain't working on something, but yeah.
No, he's not working on the boxing aspect.
I think Tyson Fury just a better
boxer. Why I just see him in the gym for 13 hours a day, just just hitting a body bag with one hand. For 13 hours a day. Like,
that's it.
Because that's all he was doing in the fight. He was just using his one hand. Right. So, you know what I mean? I felt kind of bad watching it after a while. I'm like, why am I feeling bad? No, nigga, this a fight. Like, nigga,
you
can't.
You signed up for this.
You signed up for that shit.
Like, you be
you
right.
Talked your shit. You said he had. You made everybody feel like he had. No, now I got to feel bad for him because you made everybody feel like he had fucking brass knuckles.
Right. And
or hitting you
shit.
With bare knuckles that his
None
gloves
that.
Ain't have
that
all the patent.
Hit hard,
no.
Nigga.
They checked this shit before this. And I feel like the hits might have hurt it a little bit worse than the last one.
Maybe you wanted
these niggas was seeing the fucking
gloves,
the birds around this shit.
Straight up.
That shit was crazy.
Straight up, man.
But yeah, you know I mean, shout out to both of y'all. You know what I mean, y'all both went in like warriors, man.
Yeah,
no tap outs, no
fight,
no towels thrown in. You know what I mean?
Yeah, that was a good fight. I can't lie.
It was a good fight, man. It's real entertaining. Y'all both got y'all's off. It's just, you know what I mean. Deontay ran out of stamina. You know what I mean? It's just stamina, player. But we gonna go to this next thing. You know what I mean?
Yeah, you know what it is, the kid Buck Bandit Reno.
Boy, you Buck Bandit pig.
And we the host of Buck Bandit Podcast, man.
Yeah, I know.
And if you don't know, we on season 2, man. So if you ain't check us out, man, make sure you check us out, man.
Definitely make sure you check us out, man. Definitely. On all streaming platforms, wherever you get your podcast.
Alright, sir. Watch the videos on YouTube.
Right.
You know what I mean? We talk about everything from entertainment, sports. Man, all the bullshit going down on the social media, everything.
I mean, if y'all out there doing some crazy shit, don't be doing some crazy shit, but we gonna talk about
it. Yeah, yeah. And definitely you can come and watch me, your boy, win 95% of the arguments too, you know, because I always know everything, you know what I mean?
That's some bullshit. I win all
the fucking. He definitely gonna win.
Next thing we talking about.
We gonna start off with this segment called Things.
I never knew.
You know what
yes,
I'm
sir.
You are, and P, I didn't know this. I don't know if you knew it, but did you know Michael Jackson is petty?
Petty as shit. I mean, I ain't know he was petty.
How petty is he? And we gonna
how
give you this.
How petty is Mike?
Oh yeah, yeah. Well, Mike is petty, man, because you know what? Back a couple years ago, Eminem dissed Mike on a song. Remember that? Mm-hmm. I don't know if you remember. I think it was I'm Eminem Slim Shady or some shit like that.
I was gonna say, Eminem used to dress up like
Mike Jackson.
So all that nut shit.
He made fun of Michael Jackson. What Michael Jackson do? He ain't call him up, get on his, shut my own shit, kick his ass or something. You know what he did?
What he do?
He bought Eminem's whole catalog at the time. And every time Eminem performed or dissed him, he got
you
paid.
Working for me now, yo.
He got paid.
That's petty.
That's all time petty, but all time genius.
That's smart. That's smart as shit, but that's petty as fuck.
That's all time petty. I give it to you. Oh, you want to diss me, nigga? Look, I got the money. Mike had money.
Bullshit.
You know what I'm saying?
That's
I'm
gonna buy your shit.
So at the same time, he had Eminem catalog, the most popping rapper at the time, and the Beatles catalog. Come on, bro.
No wonder they killed that nigga. Like, God damn. They had
he was definitely gonna be a billionaire if he wasn't already.
I was gonna say, he probably was already. Like, yo, they had to kill that nigga. That nigga, he was, oh yeah, y'all wanna do that? Okay, I got something for y'all. I'm buying catalogs, nigga. So, hey,
you know
y'all work for me now.
I heard a lot of stories about Mike being a real nigga, though. Like, everybody be getting hooked up on this persona that he put out there for y'all. From all the stories from the different comedians and artists and shit that used to hang with him, Mike was a real nigga.
I heard Mike was a real nigga. You know what I'm saying? And I, like, honestly, like, growing up now and seeing all, like, how the world is and entertainment is, Mike wasn't no bitch ass nigga. Yeah, so I could see them fucking making all that shit up about all this fucking kid shit and all that. Like, cause come to think of, like, come on, dog. Like,
trying to find a way to infiltrate his situation they can get inside the shit, see what he got going on in there, take his shit down, take his money.
That nigga
take
all
his property.
The bullshit ass cases.
Oh yeah.
How many times
he owned a lot of people's rights and all
like,
that shit too.
If you think about that shit, that's power, bro. They don't want no nigga in power. I don't give a fuck if you did paint yourself
and
white, nigga.
And he related to white people because he painted himself white, so he had the best of both worlds.
Yeah, no.
Oh
we gonna kill this nigga. We gonna discredit this nigga, then we gonna kill this nigga.
Yeah, but they couldn't. So many people, a lot of people believed it, but a lot of people like, come on now, Mike ain't doing that shit.
Exactly.
Just because he got all that shit is because he ain't get to live his childhood.
Right.
So he probably just like to see kids play around, and he got a bunch of shit. He just like to see the kids have a good time that he can have. He got beat up by Joe. You know what I'm saying? And had to perform and all the time. You know what I'm saying?
But I don't know. Mike might have not been who he was if it wasn't for Joe. Superstar out there. Nigga, you gonna be a motherfucker. Super, that's fucked up.
That's real. But at the end of at the end of the day,
that nigga,
he look what it did to him mentally.
Smart as shit.
It fucked him up a little bit. He was smart on the business side, but personally, you to do that to your face, you trying to look nothing like
this
the person who did that to you.
Bleach baths, like when I'm like bleach baths.
He didn't want to look like his dad, nigga.
What?
Like the shit that you saying he beat into him. He probably felt like he could have been that star if he just loved him more.
Yeah,
you know what I mean. So. You might feel like that strategy worked and it might have came out and worked like that, but maybe it could have worked the same way if he tried to do the same thing but with more love. You know what I'm saying? Like, that's why people commit suicide and all that shit.
Straight
because
up.
they relive that moment over and over again. You know what I'm saying?
But yeah, shout out to Mike.
But
that
shout out to Mike, man.
Petty as shit.
All time petty. You know what I mean? The G, rest
petty
in peace.
LaBelle like a
month. I never knew.
You already know. Rest in peace, the legend. And the next thing we gonna get into, man. And we show love to people every show. And P, what's this thing we call this thing right here?
The All Star Spotlight.
You already know this the All Star Spotlight, man.
Who we got this week?
And this week,
we got
the funny. You know what I'm saying? You remember we was watching The Office, John, the unspeakable things he did to the motherfucking...
unspeakable thing.
To the motherfucking... Yo, this week's All-Star Spotlight, to hear more, man.
It's the Buck Bandit Podcast. Hey, it's the Buck Bandit Podcast. Hey.
All deaf digital. You know what I'm saying?
You already know.
He funny on the stand-up side.
Mr. No Neck.
You know what I mean? Mr. No Neck.
He
gonna chop us the fuck up. He gonna chop us the fuck up for that. But it's cool. We'll take that. You know what I mean?
They be cutting Tahira. Tahira definitely a GOAT. Definitely shout out to him.
Because it's not even about, like, giving out the joke. Sometimes you gotta be good enough to take a joke.
You already know.
You know what I mean? Cause sometimes it's funnier the way you take the joke. You straight know what up. I mean?
You definitely gotta be able to take the joke, take a punch, unlike some people who got knocked out this weekend.
Oh man. Oh man.
But yeah, shout out to Tahir Moore.
Shout out to Tahir Moore, man. He got a lot, he doing a lot of touring right now. So yes, stand sir. Up, we looking forward to maybe a special or something.
Yes, you sir. Know what I'm saying? That'd be a good joint.
Yeah, you know I mean, we got we like to see it, you know what I mean? And we definitely wanted to see them bring the Roast Me Classroom back.
You gotta
y'all bring gotta bring that back. That shit was fucking that hilarious. Was
hilarious. Niggas getting sent to detention for whack ass jokes.
Oh yeah. That'd be funny too. That just be saying funny. The bombing on the joke and the way niggas get sent to detention be funny.
That shit be funny. It should be like, all right, man, I gotta send you to detention. Yo, yeah, that shit classic.
So shout out to Tahir Moore, man. You definitely an all-star this week, man. Keep right doing up. Your thing. Keep doing your stand-up. You know what I mean? Keep doing your improv and all shit and all that. You know what I mean? Keep yes, doing sir. Your heat check. You know what I'm saying? You yeah, already yeah. know, man.
Yes, sir.
We always going to show love, man, every week. You got never to. Know who we going to show love to, man.
Got to. Got
it could go love. Anywhere, man. It could go to Pauly Shore. It could go to motherfucking yeah. Mike Rashad. Shit, it could come around, go back to Eddie Griffin. You yeah, know what I'm saying? Man. We go anywhere.
Straight up.
You ain't never there. You know what I'm saying? But this next thing straight we going to get into.
Yo, man. It's your boy, Stu, a.k.a. Stu Artur, a.k.a. Mr. Uh-huh.
Yeah. 15 couple baggies minus the gat they almost had. If I was with my dog, he would've took the case, no shag. Try and get to my destination like a nab. You ain't gonna wear my nigga just like some plan B. I gotta get to it.
Make sure
to
go download, subscribe, check out my new music. 38 Volume 2 out right now featuring Tilla. Who shot your visual album now on YouTube? We got Flaming Freestyle flow out right now. Make sure to go check out and listen for the Opposition dropping on the 22nd. Make sure to go check out my new interview out now where we run the streets, man. Mr. Aha, man. Just get it.
Like the rock while we broke in half. I know some niggas turn the pookie star hitting glass.
Cause you know what I mean? We can always use a couple laughs. You feel me?
For sure.
In this video, I'm gonna tell you about basically, you know, a wife, a husband taping his wife that cheated on him. She admitted she cheated on him. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, y'all watching the video right now as we speak about it.
Well, I caught you lying. You got mad.
I did.
Okay, and then when you got mad, you went and fucked somebody else.
I was mad at me.
Okay, but you went and fucked somebody else.
I did.
Because you got caught lying.
Yes.
And now this person is now.
Because I was mad at me.
Now this person is now texting you saying that he was with you actually all night.
He was not.
Okay, but so he's lying.
He is lying.
Okay.
He is lying. That's a big fat fucking lie.
He said last Friday night. What does Katy Perry voice mean?
I have no idea. I don't know what he's talking about.
So he's lying.
I think he was with somebody else before he got to me. That's what I think.
Okay. Well, he thinks he had sex with you all night.
He didn't.
Did you blow him near the couch?
Yes.
Okay. Well, he talked
right when he walked in the door.
Okay, so wait, right when you walked in, you went out sucking his dick.
Yes.
Okay. Well, he references that. So he knows it's you.
Yeah. Okay.
He's talking about being with you all night.
He wasn't.
Okay.
We didn't leave the restaurant until 10:30. You just okay. heard that.
Okay.
Well, there was well, nothing but, to preface
but she didn't say that you weren't with him as well.
Call her back. She probably won't take the call since you hung up on her, but go ahead and call her back.
Okay, now, do you feel bad at all that you did what you did?
Oh, my God.
What?
Fuck yes, I do.
What do you feel bad about?
I feel bad that, well, for 100 different things, I feel bad. Starting at the end and working backwards, I felt absolutely terrible that I cheated on you.
Mm-hmm. Well, I mean, do you feel bad that you lied to me?
Well, I was getting there. I told you I was working from the end and going backwards.
Okay.
The worst thing that I've ever done is hurt you.
Okay, so tell me more about the logic of you fucking getting caught lying and then you go suck some other guy's dick because I caught you lying. How does that work?
Was an absolute whore and deserved to be treated like one. It was self-mutilation.
You know what I mean? But she admitted she cheated on him. Uh-huh. She said she sucked his dick soon as he hit the room.
As soon as he hit the room.
As soon as he came in the door. You know what I'm saying?
Came in the door with the full real shit.
And that shit crazy, man, because, like, just speaking out of terms in this video, because this shit is funny. A female admitting to you that she fucked somebody else, then saying she sucked the shit out of his dick. Okay. Like, what type of scene? That had to be a white person to just tape it and just, hey, man. You know what I mean? We see the video. We see it's a white person, but ain't no black person going
okay,
to
so you.
Niggas
ain't
is getting beat
to,
up. They,
you ain't saying that to
they
no
dying
nigga.
Something.
You ain't saying that to this nigga. I'll tell you that right now.
No.
And nigga gonna be like, what, bitch?
You did what?
Bitch, I'll fucking kill you.
Yeah. So that's crazy, man. There's a lot of people out there that's going through that type of shit. And the only way somebody can stay with somebody like that is like, if you can't get nobody else, a bitch gonna admit to your face that, yeah, I fucked other people. And I sucked his dick as soon as he walked in the door.
Damn.
Like, oh no, bitch.
Yeah, that's
oh,
a
no.
bad joke.
Oh no, violation. Violation station. Pew, pew, everybody gonna die. Real shit.
That's a bad joke. Yeah.
That's a super bad joint.
So
you know what I mean?
Nigga.
Oh no! Oh no! Oh no! And if it did, yeah. a nigga like me, it wouldn't happen to a nigga like me.
That
I'm sorry.
Whoop, whoop, nigga. Yeah. Somebody ass gonna
oh,
get
yes.
whooped, and
somebody's gonna get locked up.
And somebody gonna get hit. Cell,
and somebody gonna get locked up. That's two things we know for sure.
For sure. I don't know nothing
oh,
else.
Oh, you gonna tell me to my face? Bitch, you that bold?
And you sucked it? Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
No,
yeah, I'm not saying hit a woman, but if any time was a time where to get a hit a woman pass, that would be it. You know what I'm saying?
That's fucked up. Disrespectful.
Real shit. So the next thing we gonna get into, man, so we can... That shit was crazy. You know what I mean? We gonna go to unforgettable moments.
Yeah, unforgettable.
You know, I gotta hit that every time. That's our shit. You know what I mean? This week's unforgettable moment. You know what I'm saying?
What's
you
that?
Remember Dog the Bounty Hunter?
Everybody knew Dog, bitch.
Getting canceled because that he said, nigger. You nigger? He said, nigger. That's what he said.
Motherfucking nigger.
Well, this unforgettable moment was him explaining why he thought he could say nigga.
During that call, you used the N-word.
Yes, sir.
Why were you using that word so freely?
Well, I thought I had a pass in the black tribe to use it, kind of like Eminem.
Who gave you the pass?
The brothers.
I don't know how the fuck he thought he could say
that. Oh, he, you know why? Because the brothers told him he could.
What brothers?
That's what I'm trying to figure out. The KKK brothers?
Right.
Because we don't call each other brother.
And we don't
they
call
do.
Each other nigger. Like.
You know what I'm saying? That too.
What?
So we're brothers. We're brothers. Okay, man. That shit, motherfucker. Because
you already know. The Klan, like you said, that's the Klan brothers.
The brothers,
brotherhood.
The brotherhood said it was cool. If I said it. That's what it had to be.
Yeah, I'm happy they canceled that motherfucker. Certain things you can't motherfucking say unless you wanna get your ass whooped. Fuck that.
At like, the end of the day, it's a racist ass bounty hunter. He looking
who
for you
niggas
and you
up.
Butt.
He locked oh, niggas up shit. For a living, bro. Yeah. You definitely can't say nigga. Like,
yo, yeah.
And under any circumstances, mm-hmm. a nigga could be in your house robbing you, then you still can't call him a nigga.
Real shit.
Like, bro,
no.
you can't do that, no. dog. Fuck
no.
that. He said,
you know what I mean?
The brothers said,
the brothers.
Who are these brothers?
Who are the brothers? Put them on blast right now.
Please, yeah, I need names.
If you any got, of them black.
Yo, rah, rah,
no,
Raheem,
I need a picture.
Rocky.
Who?
Khalil and them. And like, you gotta say something, nigga.
You got
like,
the wrong got brothers.
The brothers, yeah. Bobby and Swinston down there. I mean, look
at
them.
At
like,
the, I get the country club, motherfucker. Those are the only motherfuckers.
Fuck
no, it's really? Okay. He got back around the brothers. They said, hey, man, not in front of them. What the hell are you doing?
We only say it here, behind closed doors.
Oh, shit.
What the fuck?
You know what I mean? I never was into his shit anyway. I think I might have seen the episode, and I'm like, what the fuck?
Yeah,
this
I've
is
seen
a
it
show?
Times. Anybody watch
this is a show,
shit.
But you know what I mean? He got his whole family. This
fuck
is
him
a show.
And his wife. Fucking fuck both.
You know what I mean?
Straight up. Locking but, niggas up for a living.
Yeah, that
you
definitely
ain't even
was
a real
time
cop,
to kill.
Nigga.
No.
You
no.
A
you're a bounty hunter.
Book him. All you
yeah.
want, nigga.
That
white
nigga definitely book him. He
white
book him.
Him.
Fuck
out
of here.
Straight up.
You know what I'm saying?
Like I said, the brothers said, meet these fucking brothers so I can whoop their ass.
No, that's real shit though. And this last thing we gonna get into, you know what I mean? Cause you know, every week we gotta do it. Every week.
Yes, sir.
You know what I'm saying? And this week, something to watch.
What's on your watch list?
What's on your watch list? You know what I'm saying? P, we gonna get into something to watch, man. Something P gonna give watch. You something to watch.
You already know.
Something to watch. Something to watch.
You already see know this, what this, time it is. I gotta give a shout out to my boy Keenan Grace, man. He hosts his channel on YouTube, stock channel. If y'all trying to invest in some stocks,
you always in some money up. Shit.
That's you all it is about getting a bag. If you ain't getting the bag, then you gonna be last, and I'ma laugh. Nigga, mm-hmm. I ain't that. But yeah, shout out to Keenan Grace. Make sure y'all go search his YouTube channel. He funny as shit. Probably one of the best YouTubers on there because he just be going in about stocks. That shit funny as shit. So make sure y'all check out my guy Keenan Grace on the tube. Or on the gram, wherever y'all want to follow him at. But that's something to watch, his YouTube channel. Check okay. him out, Keenan Grace.
Okay, okay. Shout out, yes, shout out.
Gotta and, give him a shout out, man. That could have been the motherfucking, you know what I mean, all-star spotlight. But you know what I mean? Gotta
man, give look, a shout out. You never know. Gotta you never know, out, man. We going on forever. Anybody can hit the all-star straight spotlight up. If they doing what they supposed to do.
Straight up.
You know what I mean?
But, yeah, shout out to my guy, Keenan.
Shout out, shout out. And this week, my something to watch. You know what I'm saying?
What's that?
Listen, they didn't bring the classroom back, but Roast Me Battle. One-on-one roast with comedians, some of the top roasting comedians in the game. You know what I'm saying? Check them out. You know what I mean? Roast Me Battle on All Def Digital. You know what I mean? Host Brandon Lewis is definitely funny. They going head-to-head. Clashing, you know what I mean, on the comedy side.
That's
and it's kind of like how it was in the classroom when you, like, it'd be a lot of people in the classroom, but it's just y'all two going back and right. forth. But they just take out the classroom and it's just y'all two. So I like that shit.
Like a good joke.
Oh, yeah, it's funny as shit. If you need a laugh, you know what I mean? You go learn about some money and then you go get the funny. You know what I'm saying?
You
can always combine the two. You know what I mean?
Know that.
As long as ain't nothing funny about your money. You know what I'm saying? You
feel me? Funny money out here.
No funny money. But yeah, that's my this week something to watch, man. Roast Me Battle. Make sure you check that out on YouTube. It's free. Why not? You know what I'm saying?
Check it out. You already know.
Yeah, so it's been another good episode, man.
Yes, sir. Always is.
Episode 36.
36. Pick up the sticks.
You know what I'm saying? We in here.
Talking about.
We in this bitch. We got a lot of things coming.
Yes,
you know
sir.
What I mean?
Yes,
make sure sir. You subscribe to the YouTube yes. channel. We know you're checking it out.
Yes,
we
sir.
See you. Thanks for the comments.
Yes,
thanks
sir.
For the love and the shout outs. Matter of fact, we're going to show while we ending this show off the couple people who showed us some love
yes, sir.
On these past episodes.
Tell a friend to tell a friend.
Make sure you tune in. The listeners, go to YouTube, type you in Buck Bandit know. Podcast for episodes you want to watch. You know what I mean? If you're watching yes, us sir. Right now, go listen to us on the pod. We always keep right. extra shit on the audio
you
side.
You never know what you're going to hear. You never know.
You never know,
you
man.
Know
and there's a lot of things going down. Oh, yeah. I got a new artist. Make sure you check out my new artist,
yes,
Stu
sir.
Artillery. You know what
fire.
I mean? A lot of work
Street
coming in.
Fire. Dylan's you know I mean? Been hot fire.
Yeah, we got things coming on. He definitely going to be on the show next week.
You
know what I mean?
Know.
So we gonna get this shit popping, talk about some good shit next week.
Yes, sir.
You know what I mean?
As usual.
We trying to get P to come up with a new segment. We going to see what we going to do in the workout tip, man. We got to do something with that.
You already know.
We got to, man. This motherfucker Hulkamania in the gym.
Let's
you know what I'm saying?
It.
So,
let's get
you know what I mean? Like we said, it's episode 36. We out this bitch. It's Buck Bandit Reno.
Your boy Buck Bandit P.
Let's get it.
Buck.
Time for nothing. Ain't got time for nothing. Ain't got time for friends. Ain't got time for coffee. But I can make time for loving. Ain't got time for this. Can't waste time on that. Can't waste time on you. 'Cause I can't rewind the back. Ain't got time for nothing. Ain't got time for friends. Ain't got time for coffee. But I can make time for loving. Ain't got time for this.
Can't waste time on that. Can't waste time on you. Cause I can't rewind it, but I ain't got time for nothing. Act like you mean more than my grind or something. Act like you been on my mind or something. Yeah, little bitch, you a dime a dozen. She